Today I'd like to talk to you about how to lure and capture Japanese beetles. Japanese beetles are a big problem all over the country, and in this case we're in the United States and I live in northwestern Pennsylvania. Japanese beetles attack many varieties of plants and trees here, and they're attracted to the scents of flowers. For example, my tea roses get attacked by the Japanese beetles at the bud stage, and they just suck the life right out of it before the blooms even develop and fully open. So it's easy to get people excited about Japanese beetles, and they're fast in buying chemical treatments and pesticides in order to deal with them because they want them dead and out of the way immediately. Here on my property, I don't like to use pesticides, and even for weed control, I don't use herbicides. My natural pest control for bugs of all different kinds is actually poultry. I have African guineas that cruise the property all day long, collecting bugs, ticks, for example. Insects of all kinds are controlled very well by free-ranging poultry. Unfortunately, chickens, for example, like to eat Japanese beetles, as do the guineas, but they can't reach them everywhere. And it's easier in some cases to lure the Japanese beetles in away from your plants and collect them. And then the question after you've collected them is what to do with the beetles. I'm going to show you how to recycle Japanese beetles. One of the best methods of dealing with Japanese beetles is to trap them. To do that, you have to have a trap. And I'd like to show you my favorite trap from a company called Tanglefoot. And I'll explain why this is my personal favorite design. First, let's go over the features of the trap and how to put it together. They're kind of expensive. I guess they go for $11 or $12. But compared to what will happen to your property if you use chemicals, I think this is a great remedy. Plus, these traps can be used year after year. They don't wear out. So first of all, there's the funnel portion of the trap. It's pretty slippery, and so when beetles bump into the vanes that are at the top of this, they fall into the funnel, and then they go into a collection system underneath. Now, different companies make beetle traps, and often you'll see the plastic bags hanging underneath the Japanese beetle trap. I don't like that method, and I'll explain why in a minute. The Tanglefoot system has a plastic base, and you just pull it out. It's full of holes, for example, so if it were to rain into this, the water comes out and it doesn't just drown your beetles and make a big stinky mess. So it's also designed to receive the top. It just clips in, and then you turn it and it's locked in place. And this is how it appears in the yard. The other part of the system are the vanes that it suspends from. So you put these together. They lock together, and there's a loop at the top that it suspends from. And then, of course, there's a lure that goes inside of this. You'll see that there are slats here and here. This is the lure system that comes with the Tanglefoot trap. You'll notice that there are two different designs of lures inside of it. One is a floral lure, which means that it puts out the scent that some of your best plants might when they're in bloom. And that also lures the Japanese beetle. The other, of course, is a pheromone lure, which is a sex pheromone, both for male and female Japanese beetles, and that attracts them to your trap. So you want to put your trap downwind of the plants that you're trying to protect, so that the first pheromone lure that they encounter doesn't come from actual beetles on a plant, but rather from the pheromone in your trap. Then all you do is peel off the back. Now this lure is open on one side. The side that's open is the side that you face to the center of your vanes here. You put one side in the slat on one side and the other side of the lure and the vanes on the other side. And this is how it sits in the trap. It's only on one side. Then you take it and you'll see that there are receiving holes inside this funnel. And you just clip it in, and then this hangs. And you want to hang it at least 3 feet off the ground and up to 4 feet, for example. Don't put it so high that it's difficult for you to go and retrieve it. And then to empty the beetles from the trap, you just turn it drop this out, and then you can carry around a mason jar, for example, that's full of soapy water, and then you empty each trap into that, and then you replace this. And you can hang these from a rope, or you can, for example, use some of those yard supports that people hang their little flags on. Those are really good for hanging up your Japanese beetle trap. Now, one of the reasons I don't like the bag design is because every time you get the bag full of beetles, you're going to have to throw that away, and then you buy new bags. I don't like to buy bags, and I think $6 plus is crazy for three plastic bags. The other thing that people tend to do, because they've paid so much for the bags and they know that replacing them is an expense, they let the beetles accumulate and accumulate inside these bags until they're really huge, and then you see the support system for the trap bending over and lowering to the ground. And another thing that happens then is the beetles die inside of it, they excrete their own juices, and they really start to smell. And when these bags start to stink, if you can smell it, it's already too late. By the time these bags start stinking, the lure no longer works, the trap no longer works, because the beetles won't come to the smell of a pile of dead beetles. So if you use these, you're buying them and replacing them all the time, and you're throwing them in the trash, and they stink. The other thing is that your dog can chew into it, and in my case, my chickens and other poultry come and peck at them until they start to get the beetles out, and then half the beetles fly free. The other thing that you have to replace on a trap like this one is, of course, the pheromone lure and the floral lure. I did a little experiment with this myself because I'm wondering, do you really have to replace that lure every 6 months or every season, for example? I've left traps out year after year with the same lures, and I've got lures this year that are 2 years old and they're still attracting beetles. And I don't put them in Tupperware, I don't seal up the lure through the winter, I just leave it open air, and I hang these, in fact, in my garage in the off season. So they still attract Japanese beetles when the lures are 2 years old and then a year old, but I have noticed that they attract fewer and fewer beetles as the lures are older, and that's to be expected. So what if you want to replace a Japanese beetle lure? Tanglefoot sells, of course, the bait, the lure itself, and they're $5.79 for one. So again, there's another expense. So if you want to change it every year or every 6 months, if you're in an area that gets a broad season of Japanese beetle assaults, then I guess you're going to be hit for quite a bit of money for buying replacement lures.